First of all, I will like to excuse for my bad English, but I will try to do my best about this presentation, Guinea preventing and responding to Ebola crisis. I will start with some strategic question because it's crucial to know what is the background. Could this recent Ebola outbreak have been predicted? Why was the magnitude of the outbreak so high? And could the extension of the outbreak have been contained? Could the Ebola virus disease happen again? And why did the local community react negatively? Why so much rumor, misperception? What are the role of the country and international community and the future for globalization? This is a very important question that people use to raise at a different level, saying related to this Ebola outbreak. And now, the impact of this recent outbreak, as you know, Guinea was the epicenter of this Ebola outbreak, and how Guinea can contribute as a in the research and development side with regard to this huge outbreak. What we learned that this is the first time people used to say that health can have an impact and social economical growth, but this is the first time in Guinea that people realize that health issue can stop every single thing in the country, including travel, including the airport, including mining company, including trade, and all these together. It was a very big shock to community first and also to political leader. And at the end of the day, people was just say, oh, this is the banal things, it's not very serious, and we will deal with our business. But at the end of the day, people realize that is a very crucial thing, and health can be a big issue in that context. One of the problem also was the communication. You couldn't imagine with these mass media and international global media can impact at the community level. When my my aunt, my cousin in the rural and remote area can listen to CNN, on BBC, on France 24, saying, oh, this can be worse. And the first message was saying, there is no medicine, no therapeutic, and no vaccine. And we encourage people to go to the health facility. They say, why am I go to the health facility to die? No, I don't want. They go to another place. And that was a very big challenging situation. As I've said, Ebola was a very, very unprecedented outbreak in West Africa, and Guinea was the epicenter. WHO have organized a set of meetings in Geneva. The amazing thing was, in terms of research of development, there was a plan for Liberia, where NIH from United States was helping Liberia to conduct a clinical trial. And Sierra Leone, there was CDC and also London School to support them. But for Guinea, there was nothing. We said, what happened to support Guinea? And that's the reason we asked WHO to support Guinea to organize a clinical research. And the reason for Guinea asking that request is the potential reduction of the magnitude of disease. And we started implementing the therapeutic like favipiravir, plasma convalescent, interferon, and ZMAP. And also, we were thinking that vaccine can interrupt and stop the outbreak as soon as possible. And we started the two components of clinical trial. The first one is the ring vaccination. We tried to vaccinate around the Ebola positive case, vaccinating contact and contact of contact and all the neighbors around a ring. And also the other thing is how this vaccine can impact and frontline workers beyond health worker at the hospital. That was the second component of the study. And lastly, the country will benefit for capacity building, and we made a lot of training and to let people be able to conduct clinical trial on the field. That was not a very easy task. If you have to conduct clinical trial in so dangerous and deadly context, it's very challenging. I remember as a co-PI involved in that study, when you go to the field as quick as possible, you never know who is who. And we are vaccinating a contact, contact of contact, and some contact was a very highly contact. And 2 days after, they were sent to the treatment center because they was positive. And we were together working that contact. And it's a very important development. Roughly, the magnitude was very high. As you can see, there was two waves. The first intervention was the first wave. We had more than 3,800 cases. Among them, the case fatality rate was 67%. And after that, some time ago, we were facing a sexual transmission. And 3 months later, we had a transmission through the sexual In total, we had 3,800 and more than 2,500 cases. I was in Kikwit for Ebola in 1995. That was quite different because the extension was different. It was another context, and the geographic context limited the extension of the disease. That was not the case in Guinea because there was a lot of movement, a lot of mobility and migration also. People, cases, contact, deadly, all these make a lot of factor to transmission. This is roughly the epidemic curve. There was more than 6 waves. When we are thinking that we are over to the control of the epidemic, he start again. And it was a very, very challenging for all the people. Despite we had a chance to implement convalescent plasma, favipiravir, interferon, and a new innovative lab test like rapid test for Ebola. And now we are about the survival study testing the immunity of these people. Now, what was the main strategy to develop on the field? It was surveillance and contact tracing, lab confirmation, that was a very crucial step also, case management, and we had a lot of partners working on that, infection prevention and control of infection, adequate and dignity burial, and community and social mobilization, as well as coordination. We had a lot of partners. It's amazing, but it's quite important how to coordinate such kind of intervention. Just some picture with a wall isolation treatment center. And you can see this is the high risk area. People is walking on this area. This is some also for staff to relax and to have a lunch. Now we conduct the vaccine trial, and we are happy to see that we had a very promising phase three clinical trial result that was published in the Lancet. Guinea was the only country who can be able to conduct a phase three trial. Phase three trial is to conduct a trial during the epidemics. When Sierra Leone and Liberia started, there was no cases because the disease and the outbreak was interrupted. And for this case, I couldn't say we are lucky, but we had a chance to test the only phase three clinical trial on the field. And that was very challenging, as I've already said. People say, okay, we were the epicenter that can be a contribution to global health science on this. Now we are also dealing with survivor, because we saw the resurgence of the disease through sexual transmission. And you can see how the magnitude is. And the epicenter was in this region, in the forest region. He moved from migration, mobility to Conakry, the capital. And some of the district was not attended, but most of them notify some cases. What was the challenges we are facing? The better understanding of the disease, because that was a very new thing for people. People was dying, and there was a lot of rumors saying, oh, this is the government who's inventing these things just to disturb people. And there was a lot of communication issue also related to this outbreak. Migration issue impact a lot of population, people. And people was very shocked about the death and the magnitude, the case fatality rate also. We had a lot of problem with principle of good clinical practice to conduct a study in a emergency situation, as well as to take into consideration the ethical issue and the regulatory also pathway, because it's not easy just to test the vaccine, but the vaccine need to be licensed. If you have no product license, is not going to be used in widely aspect. And also, one of the problems we are facing, the virus is circulating. How the virus can be in contact with the human, and human are more and more aggressive to the forest and entering to the soil. But I think we need to look for also these ecological study as well as the animal reservoir. And we are also taking advantage for all the science related to variability and sequences, and also country capacity building. We took the opportunity for capacity building, as you have already seen, but one of our orientation is how we can work together, these three affected countries in the Mano River Union, like Liberia, Sierra Leone, and Guinea, as well as Côte d'Ivoire. We are in the political context of the sub-regional collaboration. For us, this is the way we can strengthen the partnership. And we had also the chance to have a very strong partnership, including all the UN institutions, bilateral cooperation, academia, NGO, manufacturer, regulator, ethic review board, etc. I think that also can be a lesson learned here. But the lack of communication during the crisis makes things worse in our context. Misperception, ignorance, lack of confidence of the community. How can you imagine that we are trying to help people, and people, some community, attacks health workers and kill them? Why? Because for them, they are coming to kill them, and the only reaction is to kill them also. And it was very, very difficult situation. As I've said, mobility, migration was a very, very challenging. Could you imagine some people, because Ebola disturbed the ceremony and the behavior of the community, ceremony of burial ceremony and the death ceremony, all together was a very challenging and change. We had also learned a new technology. When I was in Kikwit, the first cases to be the diagnostic have to be sent from Kikwit to Kinshasa, and Kinshasa to Belgium, and Belgium to CDC. Could you imagine? We made more than 2 weeks before the result of the cases. Now, people was thinking just in terms of 4 hours was not enough in our country, because before people have a burial process, they have to be sure that it's a cases for confirmed cases or not. That was also a very challenging. We had a lot of leadership, ownership of the research with various partners to be strengthened. And the resilience of socio-economic development, health system strengthening was also challenging in Guinea perspective. What is the main home take messages for us? Health crisis impact negatively the socio-economic development in Guinea. And what change determinant that impact the human life and the future? Better prevention than responding to crises like a fireman. We need to prevent and to be more preventive in that situation. We, as I've already said, focusing on sub-regional Ebola research partnership. Thank you so much.